The sacred is revealed in the ordinary. There is a beauty in this. But how do we discover the mystery of the sacred in our seemingly mundane existence? Welcome to Revealed, a podcast sponsored by Resurrection Catholic Parish in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Let's join our hosts, Katie McAllister and Tony Pickler, as they explore the lives of people, organizations, and resources that will help us delve into the sacredness of the ordinary.
Welcome to our next Revealed podcast. We are so excited for you to join us. And what is awesome is this is episode number 9. We are about to hit double digits.
Did I hear a niner in there?
You did hear a niner in there.
Oh my gosh. This has been an incredible experience. We have had such a great rotation, I think, of interesting people mm-hmm. who have found ways to tell us about how the sacred is revealed in their ordinary lives and sometimes not so ordinary lives. We've had really great organizations represented here on the podcast so far and many, many more to come. And then we've introduce people to spiritual practices mm-hmm. that help them to get into their lives and how they're connected to the spiritual and to the holy. It's been a great experience so far.
Yeah. And today is our second practice that we're introducing to you. And I'm kind of excited for it. Tony, what is it?
Hey, we are going to break some new ground. We are going to expose all of you listeners to a new practice. At least we think it's a new practice mm-hmm. called Auditio Divina.
Auditio Divina. Is that like a car from like Europe or something like that? Auditio? What is Auditio?
Well, Auditio Divina, I mean, it does exist out there in the world. Mm-hmm. If you Google it, you will find that in Europe, there's been some scholarly work around it. Usually it's done, written in about in other languages that I don't understand.
I was going to say, hence why I've never heard of it before, yes.
Right. But in the United States, it's really not present. But what it is it's linked to a couple of practices that maybe some of our listeners are a little familiar with. One of them is called Lectio Divina. And Lectio Divina, so it's a Latin word, right? Mm-hmm. So do you know Latin?
No.
No, me either. But I do know that Lectio Divina means sacred or divine reading. And so usually Lectio Divina is done with scripture. Doesn't have to be. It could be a poem or something, but usually scripture. Mm. Visio Divina is a newer practice in which... and that stands for divine seeing or sacred seeing. And that's usually done with like works of art, paintings or sculptures or whatever, and using the visual experience. And so Lectio Divina, sacred reading, Visio Divina, sacred seeing. Guess what Auditio Divina stands for?
Audio listening, hearing.
Listening. Holy or sacred or divine listening. So we are breaking some new ground with this. We're going to do it in the similar fashion that we would do Lectio Divina or Visio Divina with 4 steps. You want to know what they are?
Well, yeah, of course I do.
Or you really don't have a choice as a co-host of the show.
Yeah.
So
no, tell me, educate me, please.
The 4 steps. The first step is called Lectio, just as in the title.
Okay.
Lectio is... reading. So if you were doing this with scripture, you would read a scripture passage and you would pick out as you read it the first time what word or phrase struck you. Mm-hmm. So we're going to do the same thing with a song. The second step is meditatio. Any idea what that means? Get into your Latin.
Meditation.
Yeah, meditation. So we're going to ponder or reflect upon what that word or phrase means. Okay? We're going to do that in a song too.
Makes sense.
The third is oratio. Now, this might throw you off because it kind of doesn't reflect what the word really is. Okay? Meditatio is too easy for you.
Yeah. Oreos? Something to do with Oreos?
Good guess.
Like we're in the cream of the Oreo here?
Wrong. Oratio stands for prayer. And so after a third, in this case, listening to a song, or if it was Lectio Divina, reading the scripture, you're actually going to just sit with that for a moment and pray. Say a prayer with your word or your phrase. Make sense?
Kind of like how I sit with Oreos and just be with one with an Oreo.
This is better for you.
Okay.
The fourth is contemplatio. Contemplatio, which is, come on, now it's a gimme.
Okay, it has to be a contemplation.
Contemplation. Yes. And in this way, we're just, after the fourth listening, we're going to just sit with our word or phrase, what struck us in the song, and we're just going to let that sink deep into us. So that's how, that's the four steps of Lectio Divina, Visio Divina, but now in this groundbreaking practice brought to you by Revealed Podcast.
Trademark Resurrection Parish.
Thank you very much. Auditio Divina.
Very good. Oh my gosh. I am so excited. So why don't we try it, Tony? Why don't we actually go through it with our listeners here?
Sounds like a plan.
You know, okay. So we got to pick a song, right?
Okay.
All right. As I kind of think of songs, what is a song that is universally known? What song has kind of been heard by millions of people, transcends generations and transcends genres? How about What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong?
That's a great choice, Katie. And you know why I love that selection?
Why?
That is a song that they always play when I'm walking home from the football games at West Appear High School.
No way.
Actually, they do play that song.
Shush.
Yes. So there you go.
Well, Tony, so even though I would love to play this whole song for our listeners, because it is an amazing song, start to finish.
I love it too.
We got a little problem. It's copyright, right? You guys know copyright. I can't play the whole song because otherwise there might be some trouble.
So how much can we play, Katie?
I think we can play 10%. If we go over 10%, there might be some issues with copyright infringement and...
Okay. I don't want to land in jail over this. So I'm hoping that our listeners are not getting their stopwatches out as we speak to see how long this segment is. But let's try it. Let's check it out. See how this works. So here's our first step in Auditio Divina. We're going to listen to What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong for a first time. Now listen to what word or phrase sticks out to you as you listen to Louis sing.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
As we come back from listening, what word or phrase really struck you in that verse? What spoke to you?
You asking me?
Not yet. Just sit with it. Just sit for a second. So
jump the gun.
Oh yeah, jumping the gun there. So what is that one phrase that really stuck with you?
Now can I go?
Yes, and now you can
Thank
go.
Thank you. For me, I love the phrase, the dark sacred nights. Love that phrase.
And for me, it was, I think to myself.
Okay. So now we're going to listen a second time, and this will be the meditatio or the meditation portion of our listening. So we're gonna play the song again and think and then reflect upon, what does that word or phrase really mean to you? Let's listen.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
So, Tony, you said your phrase was...
The dark sacred nights.
What does that mean to you?
That just stands out to me. There's so many phrases in that second verse that stand out to me. And by the way, it might be a great idea for our listeners to just go back and listen to the whole song when we're done here. But in that second verse, dark sacred nights, I love the nighttime. I love the stars. I love the moon phases. I pay attention to that. There's something, and I love that word sacred, you know, that all is holy, all is sacred. I mean, that's what we're about in this podcast, quite frankly, but that there's something sacred about when the sun goes down. Mm-hmm. And when the stars come up and the moon comes out, there's just something peaceful and sacred to me about that.
It's beautiful.
What about you?
Well, so my phrase was, I think to myself. And this was kind of twofold. I do a lot of thinking, and I do, you know, kind of process. I'm a processor. I don't know if people know this. I'm a processor. I do a lot of thinking to myself. It's reaffirming that we need to take time to think to ourselves, to take moments where we take in everything and just process it. Think to ourselves instead of reacting all the time or not being contemplative. So,
okay. That's awesome. Thank you. So now we're going to go to our third step of Auditio Divina, and that's oratio, or prayer. So we're going to listen for a third time, and then we're just going to take some time. Here you could say a prayer to yourself. You could think a prayer to yourself. You could just reflect quietly, and that's what we're going to do. So let's listen a third time.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
As we kind of come back after listening again, take some time now to just sit in prayer.
And now we bring ourselves back, and we go move to our final, our fourth step in Auditio Divina. And this time we're going to focus on contemplatio. And so after listening for this fourth time, we're just going to sit with our song, sit with these words and phrases that we've thought about, and just be in the quiet. Let's listen again.
I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
So now take time to just sit and reflect on your word or your phrase. How are you going to allow that word or phrase to permeate into your life? How are you going to take it out into your life, your ordinary daily life?
So welcome back to this podcast after this time of reflection and just sitting with the song and the word and phrase that you picked out. So this takes usually about 15, 20 minutes or thereabouts when you do Auditio Divina, depending on the length of your song, of course, and how much of that song you want to utilize. But if you find yourself short on time and you still want to engage in this type of practice, there's a shorter way to do it. Listen to the song twice. The first time, listen to the song, think about a word or phrase that strikes you in the song, just as we've done. Then listen to the song a second time and really reflect on how that song, how that word, that phrase, that verse of the song or whatever, how much you listen to, how that's really going to affect your life this week, how it's going to shape your life, influence your life for the rest of the week. So let that, don't get thrown by the fact that you need to do the entire four-step process. Lectio Divina, Visio Divina, and now Auditio Divina can be chunked down into shorter time frames.
And so there you have it. This is can be used with any song, like Tony said. It's just another way of experiences sacred in the ordinary. I'm going to go a little rogue here, Tony. You don't know I'm going to throw this out there. But we want to hear what songs you are doing this with. So I'm going to set up on our website, gbres.org/podcast. And I'm going to ask for you to submit what songs you're doing this with. What songs are speaking to you in this way? What songs give you value for practicing Auditio Divina?
That is rogue, Katie, but thanks for the invitation. And I think that's a great idea. And I know that you probably, I know you listen to songs a lot throughout your day with those earbuds always stuck into your ears.
I am a millennial, so it is part of my culture. Yeah, yes,
part of your genetic makeup here too, that you have things growing out of your ears.
Yeah.
That's great. Yeah. So send in your songs and just, again, Auditio Divina, breaking some new ground this week with this podcast, episode number 9. But we're hopefully going to bring this a little more into the consciousness of not only this area, but maybe, just maybe, the entire United States.
Dun, dun, dun.
Thanks for listening, everybody.
This has been Revealed, a podcast sponsored by Resurrection Catholic Parish in Green Bay, Wisconsin.